GearNetwork.com.
The following is a presentation of the Gear Radio Network.
Oh, hell yeah, this is Stone Cold Steve Austin, and you are listening to the greatest fantasy football podcast known to man. This is the Fantasy Football Bros Podcast, and if you like what Chaz and Jay are giving you, give me a hell yeah.
Here we go.
You are now listening to the Fantasy Football Bros Podcast.
Welcome back, everybody, to the Fantasy Football Bros Podcast. It's your boy.
All I do is win, no matter what.
Chaz. And of course, the champ is here. And, whoop, I hit it twice. Stop. I don't know why it's not stopping. We're going to have to listen to it.
Oh, man.
Champ is here, baby.
It won't stop. We're just gonna have to listen to it. Okay, I got it to stop.
You're unbelievable.
I did it. It wouldn't stop, but
I don't know how to stop it.
I see what happened. With me to my virtual left, we've got the no nickname, no nonsense.
It doesn't matter what your name is.
On one of his last days in the state
What's
of
New going York, on, guys?
Mr. Adam Van Hell, what's up?
That is true. What's going on, guys? How we doing?
You ready for your big move, bro?
I am ready.
He's going down. You're going to be home in time for the draft, right, bro?
Sure will.
Okay, Adam's moving down with country music superstar Eric Van Houten to the Nashville. So we'll give you some good luck on that later. But of course, we've got to announce that back from his 1 week sabbatical, we've got the man, the myth, the legend, Mr. Jay Coleman. Jay, what's up, dog?
What's up, guys?
How you feeling? You feeling better?
Yeah.
Yeah, you feel, especially because you got a good fantasy draft in, right?
Yep.
Can we add a draft pick thief to his list of titles, please?
We'll get there. And that voice over there, everybody, is the fantasy football.
Oh, boy. I got to hear this.
We've got Mr. Zags. So how's it going, Zags?
I brought my own belt today. What's up, boys?
Let's go.
Okay. Obviously, Chaz is the WWE. I will be the NXT version of the champion. But you were just making a guest appearance.
I think technically you have the Universal Championship.
I will take that, bro.
And I have the World Heavyweight Champion. That is actually the one from our league. That Dave split last year with Chad because of that whole silly situation. Not silly, but that whole silly fantasy situation with the DeMar Hamlin game.
Yep.
So both of you guys had plenty of players, and you all gracefully decided to split, and everybody made my life easier, so I thank you guys for that one.
The only way to do it. The only fair way to do it. The games aren't getting played. Somebody died on the field. Like, let's just split it and call it a day.
So we are here, ladies and gentlemen, to call out Jay Coleman.
Oh, wow.
We are calling Jay Coleman out here. I'm not sharing the screen right now, but I will in 1 second because I want to pull up his team here because, Dave, this bastard stole all of our fantasy crushes, did he not?
Like 1,000%.
Yeah. So, are you ready for this?
Oh, yeah, I miss. Yeah, I got to hear this.
Okay. You let's.
I can't help it. You guys didn't draft better.
let's pull this. Oh, Jay didn't even make his lineup yet. This guy.
Don't get me wrong. I love him. I love you, bro. But I'm a teensy bit mad, just a smidge upset.
All right, Adam. Here we go. We're going to share the screen now, and we're going to run over Jay's fantasy team, and we'll see if you see anything out of the blue. All right, you guys ready?
So ready.
All right, Adam.
Besides a stacked team.
Jay drafted Saquon Barkley, Josh Jacobs, Calvin Ridley, Keenan Allen, and DeAndre Hopkins, and that is literally all our fantasy.
Wow.
Is it not, Adam?
Look at this guy, dude. Saquon, Jacobs, Ridley, Keenan Allen, D-Hop.
Michael Thomas.
Michael Thomas. Wow.
Down in the bottom here, Derek Carr. That was one of your guys, right?
That was, yeah. That was
a little sneaky good, Juwan Johnson. This guy.
Literally, guy sits here and fucking, you know, silence and just learns guys, the draft board.
I got to tell you this. That's the winning roster right there.
Well,
exactly. That's the winning roster right there.
Possibly, but you know how Yahoo gives an award for best draft, Adam? You know how Yahoo does that?
Yeah.
Did
you not win it?
No, because you know who did?
Wow.
Your boy, Chaz!
Oh, God.
So let's see the fan. Let's see what they think is the best roster. And we've got on my team, went QB late, so I'm splitting between Dak Prescott and Anthony Richardson. But we got Jamar Chase, CeeDee Lamb, Aaron Jones, Miles Sanders, Amari Cooper with Breece Hall on the bench, DeAndre Swift, and Michael Pittman. So I'll take that. Plus my boy Kenny Gainwell, Zach Moss, who's going to be the starter for 4 weeks in Indianapolis right now. Romeo Dobbs, a big steal.
At least.
So I like it. I like the way my team came out because I got CeeDee Lamb. And I got Jamar Chase fifth overall and CeeDee Lamb, like what, 17th overall? Crazy, crazy talk. So I like it. We'll show Dave's real quick. This isn't the official fantasy football league yet, guys. That draft's coming up. But Dave.
Oh, this is your guys' league, right?
Yeah. Let's look at Dave's team here. Dave, of course, went with Joey.
Chris, the password is taco. Absolute gold. That was my team name like 2 years ago in one of my leagues.
Let's go, bro. Let's go.
I love it. I love it.
They've got Joe Burrow, Chris Godwin, Tyler Lockett, Nick Chubb. Who's this, Adam? Who does this?
Oh, man.
That says Bijan.
He went against everything.
Yeah, we know.
He went against everything.
Listen.
He tried to spin zone it, too.
Go ahead.
Where did you pick?
Finish up the rest of the roster before I just have a complete meltdown. If you want,
Friermuth Madison, he's got some depth on the bench with Rashad White, Christian Kirk. I like your sneaky pick of Juju there, pretty late. So, there is Dave's team. So the big controversy is that Dave shit talk Bijan forever, and then all of a sudden has him. So Dave, fend for yourself.
Listen, okay, this is how it went down. We're drafting. Where did I draft? Where I think I drafted 8th. Ten. Yeah, I think I drafted 10. So I'm in the 10 hole, right? I'll grab me some Nick Chubb. Love that pick. Who's supposed to come back to me on the turn? Either Derrick Henry or Tony Pollard. Does that happen? Of course fucking not. And then I end up with this bum.
This bum.
and then he's like, at the draft, he's like, oh, it's the second round. Like it's totally, you
it's
know,
three
it's,
picks
it's good
after.
Value. Yeah.
It's two picks after the first round. It's okay.
Yeah.
Of course, you're going to grab him in the second round. Get out of here.
Two picks into the second round. It's like, oh, it's such great value there.
Listen, okay. I stand by my word. I will trade Bijan Robinson away for Tony Pollard or Derrick Henry right now and not think twice about it.
You don't like fantasy points. It's okay. It's fine.
Yeah.
No,
I was, first of all, how is Chaz not jumping on a trade for Bijan Robinson right now? That's what I want to know.
Because I need a run in. I don't know. Because he said for those two, and I don't have those two. You know, so it is what it is.
Who are your running backs again, Chaz?
I waited on running back, so I got Aaron Jones and Miles Sanders. So.
I did the first thing that I did when I got home was check Chaz's team to see if he drafted a running back first.
Worthy of a first round pick for Bijan.
I was wondering if he went with like a Saquon or something that I could give him Bijan and like maybe a scrub on my bench for, but he did not.
No, because you guys know I don't do this. I started with two receivers. I started with Jamar Chase and CeeDee Lamb.
Yeah.
But I could not pass off Chase at 5 because in everything I say, he goes 2 or 3. And then CeeDee Lamb is sometimes getting drafted in the first round and he's sitting there, you know, 17th overall or whatever. So I just had to. So, and the other person I was thinking of taking instead of CeeDee Lamb at that point would have been Najee Harris. And CeeDee Lamb is the better pick 10 out of 10.
Yeah, for sure.
Yeah. So, and then I was okay back getting Aaron Jones, and you guys know I'm a little high on Miles Sanders. So we're gonna see what happens with it. So we won't spend a lot of time on this team because this isn't the big.
Yeah. Well, I gotta show you my draft from last night. Chaz, you'll be happy, and Dave, you'll also be happy.
Let's go.
So, well, you're not going to show. You're going to tell. It's show, not tell. Or
well, I can. So the beauty of being on my phone is that I can flip the camera on and I can show you guys.
Oh, okay. So
hopefully, if it looks okay.
Jay, while we're hanging out for a second, you see anybody on that roster you want to trade D-Hop for?
I don't know.
What about Bijan Robinson?
I'll trade you Bijan for DeAndre Hopkins and a running back.
I don't know.
Jay's thinking about it right
yeah,
now.
Yeah, let's go. Hit me up, bro. Hit me up.
You could do that, Jay. Right, you could trade me Saquon for CeeDee Lamb.
So. All right. Here we go.
Okay. Just say it, though.
Did that flip?
Yeah.
You guys see my screen here? Sorry, because Jay or Chaz, do me a favor and not share the screen right now because I got to see what I'm doing here. Yeah, all there right. We go. All right. So here's the starting lineup, right? See those two running backs right there?
Derrick Henry and Saquon. And that's what you said you were hoping for.
Saquon and Derrick Henry at number 10. I went Saquon 10. And then Derrick Henry 11.
Nice.
So it's a 10-team league. Yep.
So, see, that's what my lineup should have looked like. It should have been Nick Chubb, Derrick Henry.
Yes.
Yeah. I was even thinking that Henry might even fall to me at 8 on the backswing, and it didn't happen. So
I've seen him fall in mock drafts to like.
Yeah, exactly. That's what I was planning on.
My first four picks. It was Saquon Barkley. Let me see if I can pull up the draft here. Saquon Barkley, Derrick Henry, and then obviously because I waited on wide receiver, I ended up getting T. Higgins in the third round. And then guy, man.
I drafted him too.
And then George Kittle in the fourth. Okay.
Let's go.
See, here's what actually made me happy about what you said. You're in a 10-team league, and you took T. Higgins in the third round.
Yeah, I had no choice.
The league that Dave has with his brother, it's a 12-team league, and I got T. Higgins in the fourth round, even though I hate T. Higgins. So it made me feel better about the T. Higgins pick, because even though I don't want him.
Okay, but here's the thing. Let me tell you this. So in this league, we have keepers and dynasty. So the keeper round is a guy that you can't get rid of. Unless you can drop him, I guess, but so, and the dynasty player is a guy that you just keep whatever. So, Justin Jefferson was kept. Okay. Davante Adams was kept. And then we're looking at Tony Pollard was kept. Travis Kelce was kept. AJ Brown was kept. So there was like a lot of big names off the board already from everybody else. So listen to this. I mean, listen to the receivers that went before T. Higgins. So Jamar Chase, Cooper Kupp, Tyreek Hill, CeeDee Lamb, Stephon Diggs, and Justin Jefferson, like I said, was kept. Then it came back around, and it was Jaylen Waddle, Deebo Samuel, Davante Adams. That ends round two. And then round three is Calvin Ridley, Chris Olave, Devonta Smith. A.J. Brown was a keeper there. And then D.K. Metcalf. So, like, who would I have taken there as opposed to T. Higgins?
Garrett Wilson.
Oh, my God.
Kept. Kept in the 13th round.
Well, all right. Well, 13th round, that's fine.
Yeah, he picked him super late last year. Was able to keep him this year. So, yeah.
Yeah, no, it's all good. I just, go on, sorry.
I'll take Saquon and Derrick Henry all day long.
Yeah, oh, for sure. Absolutely.
I'm very happy with those two picks.
So that's our report. We got one major news story to discuss before we get into the meat of the matter of Jonathan Taylor has been put on the PUP, so he is not playing for at least.
Yeah, and we don't even know if he's hurt or not.
He's got to be. He's on the PUP. That means physically unable to perform. So I would assume that means he's hurt. It's not holding out. He's not. You know what I mean? Like, they don't put physically on. They'll put him on NFI, non-football injury, if they're doing something like that. So he's hurt. So to me now getting this news, even though, I mean, I still have a couple more drafts to go, I am basically out completely on Jonathan Taylor because he doesn't want to play there. He's hurt still, obviously. So that means he hasn't been practicing. It's going to take him a while to get ramped up and come back. And he's not even going to play to at least week five and still have a bye week coming up. So you're only going to get, what is that, 11 weeks out of him? You know, if that only includes the playoffs. Maybe. So if you're talking about just regular season, you're getting 8 weeks out of him. So that just makes me completely out on him. Think about this.
Yeah.
Who would you rather draft right now, Dave? JT or Alvin Kamara?
Kamara.
Right? You too, right, Jay?
Yep.
Yeah, I'm sure you too, Adam.
I did in that last draft we were just talking about. So
I don't know if you remember the running back show, but I kind of said, like, I'm totally faded on JT unless he goes into this season with a contract ready to play.
Yeah,
I'm just I'm not dealing with this nonsense. I'm not dealing with the is JT gonna play saga for 6 weeks in my fantasy season. I just want nothing to do with it.
Dave, were you ever hurt, Dave, or any of you actually, by that year that Le'Veon Bell didn't play? Me, I was personally hurt. I drafted him third or fourth overall, and like in your league, Dave,
yeah,
me the whole year. So did any of you, Dave? Did you have that problem with Le'Veon Bell at all?
No, I've actually never had that problem, and I don't want to like
you don't.
Sound like cocky about it, but it's because I never will put myself in that situation. And see, I said the same thing with Josh Jacobs. Like I don't care what the value is on the draft. If he doesn't have a contract and he's not happy, like I'm not even dealing with it. I'm
Do you
not
still
drafting.
Feel like that, even though he signed one?
No, he signed a contract. He's good to go. Josh Jacobs is back on my board. JT, on the other hand, still off my board. I want nothing to do with him.
What about you?
I'm so glad I didn't take him, JT, in the draft because he was sitting there with Josh Jacobs. And for a second, I was considering it. But because of the whole last year bullshit, I was like, nah. I'm out. And then
what happened last year, Jay?
I want to talk about it.
I was never affected by it either, actually. In one of my other leagues, I ended up trading for Le'Veon Bell. It was the year prior to that whole holdout situation. So I ended up winning the championship that year. Didn't get the first overall pick. He went first overall. Lost him the whole year. It was literally a waste of a pick.
And not only was I hurt badly by that, I believe it was the next year that I really got hurt by Ezekiel Elliott. He was going to get suspended, and it was like, he's going to get suspended sometime. Oh, he's suspended. Oh, he's appealed it, so he's not suspended. No, and he ended up getting suspended like during the fucking playoffs or something.
Yeah, he got suspended for like three games,
but it was
something
later.
Like that. But it was way later in the season, like week 11. Yep. Through like 15, and that's like, of course, before they had 17 game seasons, and right in the mix of fantasy playoffs.
Yes.
Yeah, I got screwed by him too. So
I throw shade at you guys once in a while, just jokingly that you guys are a little too conservative. But I think on some instances like that, it's okay to be conservative.
Yeah.
I do. I'm not Mr. Like, fuck, it doesn't matter on everything, you know. So that's
most of the time. almost everything.
I know I'm conservative, but I think like I don't think it's unreasonable to kind of have that strategy of like I want to know what the fuck is going to happen before the season starts. You know what I mean? Like if the whole Alvin Kamara, yeah, but like if the whole Alvin Kamara thing is still not settled yet, like I'm faded on Alvin Kamara. Or, you know what I mean? Like I don't. Alvin Kamara could get 3 games. He could get 12 games. He could get 8 games. And like, you're going into the season and you've used a draft pick on that. Like, I'm good. I'm good on all that nonsense.
Yeah. Well, basically remember, so there's a chance that Jonathan Taylor's faking an injury because he deserves more money. And Jim Irsay just said,
your opinion really doesn't matter.
Told him fuck off basically. So, all right. So that's
pretty much it.
That's our final advice for before we get into this. And it's a good segue because we are here today to help you guys with your last minute draft prep, but also not just the draft. You might listen to this a little after your draft. You know, there's some season long like tips and tricks. So this is the how to win your fantasy draft and fantasy league. Our tips and tricks. We don't know what each other's are picking. There could be 12 and there could be some crossover. It doesn't matter if there is. We're just trying to get you some best advice to help win your draft and your league. All right. So, you know, as you seen earlier, I pulled up this the spreadsheet again because I'm tech savvy now. Dave helped me be able to show it better. Thanks for that, Dave.
Chaz learned some things here.
We're legit now, boys.
I'm no longer a boomer. So we're going to get to the spreadsheet. And and all right, so this is going to be funny because it's probably going to be I'm going to be like trying to edit stuff on the way. So Dave, you don't have to give me. I don't know if you have them ranked, but if you do have them ranked, go from like 3 to 1. All right. So what is your first tip and trick to win your fantasy draft or league?
Am I doing all three in a row, or what are we doing?
Just give me one.
Just give me one. All right. I think this is probably going to sound kind of stupid, but you might be surprised how many people don't really even think about this. I think the most important thing to remember going into your drafts is to like know your fucking league. Like check.
God damn it, Dave.
I'm sorry, dude. That's I'm fine. Sorry. You got it. You got to check the scoring on your league. You have to know what positions are getting you points, what positions are not getting you points. It's going to help you determine who's actually valuable headed into your draft. If you're drafting in a league that quarterbacks only get 4 points instead of 6, like that devalues quarterbacks. Like if you're drafting in a league that's not a PPR, that devalues wide receivers. Like just look at the league settings, really understand how you're scoring points, and then it's going to help you draft the best team for that specific league.
I put that in there for you too, Adam. That's fine.
That was literally my number one tip, was to know your settings. Yeah. Figure out every league is different. So whether you're PPR, whether you're non-PPR, whether like Dave said, what points do quarterbacks get? Standard scoring on a lot of leagues is 4 points per touchdown. Yep. Commissioners change that to be 6. So know how many flexes you're going to get, or how many, you know, flex players are there. Yep. Know if it's a super flex or not, because that changes the entire draft. Quarterbacks go heavier in a super flex. Know how many guys are on your bench. Know how the waivers work. Know how everything works in your draft before getting to the draft.
Yeah, you guys are right, because like, so me and Dave are in 3 leagues together. And they're all kind of different. So, Dave, I believe your league with your brother, you guys do 6 passing point touchdowns, right?
We do 6 passing point touchdowns, and we're also one of the we're one of the earliest leagues to go half point PPR too.
Yeah, so that's what I was saying. So just like off the cuff, between your league and the Fantasy Football Bros League, you got 6 point touchdown passes and half a point PPR, where in the Fantasy Football Bros League, we got 4 point passing touchdowns and 1 point PPR.
Yep.
Completely different, changes everything. As well as Adam was saying about flex, you got 1 flex, we got 2 in the Fantasy Football Draft Bros. Yep. In your league, I just say yours, it's your brother's too, but in your league, you only have 15 roster spots because you want smaller benches for more, you know, people.
Waiver warrior action, yeah.
And I learned that from you, and I went the complete opposite route for the Fantasy Football Bros League. We have 19 spots because I think you can reward yourself by being ahead of the curve. There's nobody on waivers because you're smart enough to go get that guy. So it's all different. It's nothing's right and nothing's wrong.
Yep. You know? And I think one thing that a lot of people don't really look at, look at your point totals for yard totals. Look at that as well, because it's a thing I think people don't really understand. Standard leagues, you're getting 1 point for every 10 yards, but commissioners can change that on you. And a good example is I'm in a league where it is 1 point for every 20 yards out of your wide receiver and running backs. And it's not a, it's not like a partial point. You know what I mean? It's like a full point. You know what I'm talking about?
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. So it's not like if your running back gets you 19 yards, zero goose egg, you need to hit that 20 to get the next point. So in a league like that, I'm less concerned about yardage totals. I'm looking for dudes that score touchdowns, because it's basically touchdown or bust. So just take a look at the settings and figure out who's going to be the best for that league, not necessarily the best on the draft sheet.
Totally agree. And I know guys that I'm in leagues with that are in other leagues, and the way that the way that they're scoring is, you actually don't even start getting points for yards until they surpass 40 yards. So you don't gain any points until after that 40 yard mark, and then you get one point every 10 yards. So you're not even getting points until 50 yards rushing. Yeah. And that's 1 point. Like 1 point.
Yeah.
And it's crazy. So you do need a guy that is gonna get you yards every single week. And knowing your league settings and knowing how they're set up going into your draft is gonna help you immensely. And for that reason, and knowing, you know, who's gonna score your points and who's not. So
very good. I'm happy you guys brought that up. Jay, what do you got as a fantasy football tip and trick?
I don't have mine ranked, but I'd say you got to do mock drafts like the day of, or like the night before your actual draft. Like, don't be doing mock drafts like 3 weeks before your draft and being like, all right, I'm good to go. You got to do them like the day of, so that you get a good feel, because, you know, things change week, day to day. So you do them like the night before or the day of, if you got like a draft later at night, and do a couple so you get a good feel of like how things might play out.
Absolutely. And we show you guys at home, like, or and when we, you know, when we're building, we did a mock draft every week building up. And if you just go back and watch those episodes and listen to those episodes, you'll see the changes, you know. I'm telling you, some of my first early mock drafts and best balls, but mock drafts even. Derrick Henry, I remember getting Derrick Henry in like a mock draft in the beginning of the third round. People were so down on him for some reason, because like I think 76 wide receivers went in the first two rounds at the start of the year, but
pretty much
and everything came back to normal. Remember doing the mock drafts when we started, guys? It was like 8 wide receivers in the first round.
Yep,
that's not how either of our drafts went, Dave. There was like 4 or 5.
Yep. Yeah.
And it's just, you know, you gotta like, and Jay's right, and you gotta understand, and you gotta like know, especially if you want a certain guy. If you want that certain guy, that sleeper, if you want Trevor Lawrence and he's going in the 8th in mock drafts, you better go get him in the 7th, maybe, if you really want him, you know, and that's how you can prepare your team. I'm sure you guys agree with the mock draft pick.
Yeah, that's a great tip there.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah. And I had that on my list too, but I figured somebody would take it, so I took it off. Yeah, practice, especially if you know your draft position. I know sometimes a lot of leagues you'll get a draft position, right? But a lot of the times you can go in the draft and it just generates it very randomly as you're getting in the draft room. So if you know your draft position, absolutely do a mock draft. Put yourself in that position, see what you're looking at. That way you can kind of plan where your league is going to go.
And if you don't know your draft position, Dave's league, we pull cards the day of the draft, right before. My leagues, as you guys know, we do the Royal Rumble thing. And then I have a family league that literally just determines at random when we go in the draft. So if you don't know your position, then do 3 mock drafts, guys. Draft first, draft 6th, draft 12th, and just kind of get an idea where you're going. Because, you know, if you're drafting first, you're not going to get, say, you know, Cooper Kupp coming back at all. There's no chance in hell. Yeah. You know, like, you got to understand that. So very good call on that one, Jay. Good job. My first rule of thumb here, and it kind of goes for the draft, but more or less along the lines of your in season, it's don't tinker. Don't fucking overthink every fucking thing, guys. Don't sit there, whether it's drafting or if you're just starting your lineup, if you're just sitting there and it's like, oh, I got Derrick Henry, oh my goodness, but I've got James Conner on the bench, and he's got a better matchup for the defense because James Conner's playing Chicago and they suck at, I'm gonna sit Derrick Henry and start James Conner. Don't fucking do that. Play with your guys. Get your dogs in there, the good guys. Don't overthink things. Don't tinker. Don't sit there starting your lineup at 12:55 before the kickoff and all of a sudden change 2 players in and out. Go with your gut. Do the right thing. If you have a really big feeling, say, and taking out, you know, your tight end for a different tight end and your tight end's not Travis Kelce, fine. But, like, don't overthink things. Don't fucking be the analytics nerd and look into things about red zone efficiency, running backs, and when it's September and it's below 56 degrees and somebody farted it in the third row and this guy's gonna have better running. Don't stay to the course. Don't tinker. Don't overthink. Do things right, and it will benefit you 100% of the time.
Yeah, and definitely do this. Do this tip in your draft. Don't tinker around with your draft, so to speak. Don't overthink it. You know what the right move is. You know that Garrett Wilson over Derrick Henry is the fucking wrong move. You know that in your heart of hearts, you know that's the wrong move. So don't go way out in left field here.
I mean, it's okay to draft somebody a little bit. Say you're looking at Garrett Wilson, you know, he's the best ranked receiver on the board, and then you take Calvin Ridley, who's three or four receivers ranked later. That's okay. But if you're sitting there and looking at those guys, you're not going to go take Odell Beckham.
Right. Yeah. Yeah.
You know, it's like, you know, it's, and that kind of goes with Dave saying there's a difference between one in four guys and one in 36. Absolutely.
Yeah. If you're decent at fantasy football and you're really kind of questioning between two guys, I mean, there's probably a reason, you know what I mean? But if you're kind of like, if you're questioning between two guys and you know in your heart of hearts that like you are the one guy that you are questioning is just the fucking wrong play, like just knock it off. Just take the guy you should take.
All right. Well, all right, Dave. So let me get your number two here. What's your number two tips and tricks to win the league?
Number two for me is don't be a ranking slut. I know a lot of people that kind of just print a draft sheet off, and then regardless of kind of how the draft is going or how their team is looking, they just take the next best guy on their sheet and kind of hope for the best. Don't do that. Don't do that at all. Don't take a guy that you don't believe in just because Andy Barron says like that's the dude that you should take. You know what I mean? You use your brain a little bit, and this kind of goes back to like the don't tinker thing. Like you kind of know the right plays. Don't draft Andy Barron's team. Draft your team.
You know what? And I'm jumping in with you on this one because that's going to be my next one, which is very similar to what you're saying, and it is draft your guys. Like, have your guys and draft them. Don't go crazy. That's why Jay's idea or Jay's thing of the mock draft is something special, because you need to know where your guys are and you need to take them. So draft your guys, because the worst thing you want to do is what Dave just said, and I kind of mentioned it on the last go round of like, you're sitting there, you got Garrett Wilson on the board, and you love Calvin Ridley like me, and you take Garrett Wilson, you don't get Calvin Ridley, and Calvin Ridley finishes fourth overall this year. You will hate yourself way more than if Garrett Wilson finished fourth overall. You would be way more mad that Calvin Ridley did it than you would be happy that Garrett Wilson did it. So yeah, it's okay to listen to us. I have my guys. Adam has his guys. Dave has his guys. Jay has my guys. But like, it's okay to have your guys, and it's okay to listen to us experts and say, "Fuck you, you're wrong. This is my guy. I'm going to take him." It's completely okay to do that.
Because I'll be dead honest. I look at a lot of fantasy football quote unquote experts and rankers and all of this stuff. I don't agree with a lot of them. I've been playing fantasy football for like 15 years. You know what I mean? Like I'm not feeling great. And I know I shit on Andy Barron's a lot, but I'm not feeling great letting Andy Barron's draft my team. I'm not gonna feel great about that team when he gets out of that draft. And like, don't worry, Dave, I nailed it. I'll be like, you fucked it up.
Yeah. Absolutely. So have your guys and like them. All right. Hey, what's another tip?
Go in with a plan, but you got to plan. You got to have options. you got to plan for options. Like, for me, like I'll plan like maybe like the first four rounds of and see like, okay, you know, I'm drafting eighth overall. What players are most likely going to be there? and what players do I like those players? If I don't, and I'll write some players that I want in that spot. But you also got a plan for if those guys are gone, who you might want to take instead, or if someone, you know, we all know someone likes to fuck up the first round and they might take someone way out of left field. So then a guy might fall to you. So have a plan, you know, have some different options. Ready.
You're saying have a plan and have a backup plan.
Yeah.
Have a plan and get ready for it to go to shit.
Yeah.
Yeah. I'm jumping in too, because that was my next one. And it was, yeah, have a plan and be absolutely prepared to abandon it completely. And my, you know, it ties into the mock drafts, because when you mock draft, it's great because you can see where people are drafting and or how people are drafting and where they're going. But it's all different, right? So having a plan is great, but be absolutely prepared to abandon it. Guys are gonna pick certain guys sooner than you think, and you know
Patrick Mahomes is gonna go in the first round.
Patrick Mahomes, and around here we're in Buffalo. Josh Allen goes a lot earlier than expected. He was the first quarterback taken off the board in my draft last night in the second round.
Yeah, so it's a definitely like a flexible plan. You just have options. Yeah,
absolutely. Have a plan. Absolutely. Go do your mock drafts. Go into your draft thing. Hey, all right, I got this going on. But be prepared and be flexible and know how people are going to draft. And when, you know, you might get surprised, like you're in the fifth round or something. You're like, oh my God, I don't even have this guy. I didn't have this guy in my plan, but I can't believe he's still here. Don't be afraid to take him. Take him. Or, you know, if let's say like there's a run of wide receivers that goes, like, be prepared to be like, oh man, I'm really kind of running out of receivers here, but my plan wasn't to take a receiver at this spot. You might have to change your plan up. So have a plan, be prepared to abandon it at all costs.
Very good. I like both of those, and they're both go hand in hand, but they're different too. So that was great. I like the way that worked out. All right, Dave, what you got? What's your last tip or trick to
last tip? I might need to explain this one a little bit. And I've realized that since I've been doing a couple guest spots, I've said this a bunch and people might not really know what it means. But pick your fade point. I know you guys have said that I've said a bunch of times, you know, I'm a fade on this. And basically what it means is that it's the point at which you're totally done with a player position, right? I want you to go into the draft and pick your fade point, because I don't want you to reach on guys just because you're scared that there's been a run on a certain position and you end up drafting a player that puts you at a statistical disadvantage, right? So a good example of this is there's a huge run on TEs, right? And you end up taking a Pat Freiermuth in like the fifth round because you're super nervous that there's been a run on TEs and you need to get a tight end ASAP. Pick your fade point. When you hit your certain point, like for me, it was George Kittle. When I hit George Kittle and all the rest of the tight ends were gone, I was faded on tight end, and it didn't matter how many were going. I was out on tight ends, and I built my roster around other positions, because what it's going to do is you're giving yourself a statistical disadvantage taking the worst guy at tight end, which is already going to happen. You've already faded on tight end. You've already lost out on the points there. And by wasting your earlier pick, you've given yourself a disadvantage at another position as well, where you should have gone in and taken your flex spot. You should have taken your RB2, your wide receiver too, but you didn't. You took Pat Freiermuth because you got scared, and now you're going to end up weak at two positions. So pick a spot on your draft sheet where you're like, these are the guys that I want. And once it hits this point, like, I'm faded and I'm just waiting.
I love the way you worded that, because it was put very eloquently, because I was thinking of how to like say something like that. That was going to be one of mine too, but I didn't know how to say it. So you said it very right. Like, there's just like, and it's funny the way you mentioned it, like, was exactly the way I would have saying with the Pat Freiermuth in the fifth round. Like, yeah, yep. He's going to be fine. I know we joked about it in the tight end that you like him better than Kyle Pitts, but like, he's not worth fifth round pick by any means.
No,
because he's a okay tight end. That doesn't mean anything. You know, and let the people in your league do that, because it's going to make your life better. You're going to get the better people fall to you. But like,
right.
You know, we're all savvy here. We've been doing this for a long time, and we're trying to make people better. So very well.
Absolutely.
Yeah, so just pick a point. Pick a point on your draft sheet where you just put – I usually just put like a little line next to a certain point on my draft sheet, and I know if I don't grab anybody above this line, that position is a fade for me, and to build my roster stronger elsewhere and just come back to that position later and get what I can get.
And I did it in my fantasy, in my home league. I it's a tight ends, and I was kind of maybe a little deeper than you, probably 6 or 7. I had like Njoku was kind of like my cutoff at that point, but I had him higher than some people. Mm-hmm. And once he was gone, I just waited, and I ended up taking fucking Cole Kmet, you know, and it was just – and that's what you do. Unlike shocking pick from, I believe it was your father, Dave. Who did he take in the 4th round of the of your draft? Why don't you let these people know? So this is the 4th round.
Okay. Little Dalton Kincaid.
Dalton Kincaid. What? 4th round.
4th round, Dalton Kincaid.
Yikes.
But mind you,
God.
Mind you, folks, that Dave's dad is a defending 2-time champ. So
maybe he should be out here giving him different tips and tricks and rather than us. Because, wow, that is mind-blowing.
My dad is the sneakiest fantasy player that you will ever see. Every single year, he'll make a draft pick, and we're all like, what the fuck is going through your head? He'll pick up, like, some random fucking running back. Like, he picked up Zeke Elliott this year, right? This will be the year that Ramondre Stevenson, like, tweaks his ankle, and Zeke goes for, like, 24 touchdowns. 24. That's just how it works with my dad's fantasy drafting. It's crazy.
And, of course, your dad always takes Patrick Mahomes in the first round.
Always. Yeah, always.
So that's it. All right, Jay, you got another one?
Yep. So you want to look for late-round value, especially, like, players, you know, that some people might just be afraid of, whether it's, like, suspensions or whatever. If you can find a player that should be drafted higher, but they're in the late round, you got to snag them up.
Yep. And then like a good person on that would be like Jameson Williams.
Yep.
You know, he's a lot of people pass on him because he's and you're right. Like I found in the last draft we just did, I felt fantastic late round value in like the 15th round when I got Romeo Doubs. Like, as the 15th player on your team, Romeo Doubs could be like the 7th best player on your team. That's value right there.
Yep.
Absolutely.
Yeah, I love that, Jay. And yeah, I was going to have that, but a lot of people – so I'm in a lot of keeper leagues, and I know a lot of people probably aren't. Basically, what a keeper league is, for those of you who don't know, is you get to keep a player from the previous year, right? So – but when you keep that player, you lose essentially that becomes the draft pick the next year of wherever you drafted it. So Romeo Doubs in the 15th round, if he ends up being a top 10 receiver, you end up keeping him for a 15th pick. And maybe in mock drafts later on, you're seeing him go, you know, maybe in the 5th or 6th round. So good value there. And I love that. I love that tip, especially for keeper leagues. But yeah, I totally agree. I have Jameson Williams. He was actually my keeper player from last year. So I have him basically for free this year. I know he's suspended for 6 games, but after 6 games, we'll see what happens. And I totally agree with you, Chaz. He very well could be one of the top players on my team. We don't know because we haven't seen him play. We saw him, he played, you know, maybe 1 game and caught a 70-yard touchdown. And then that was it. When he came back from injury last year, but yeah, the late value is perfect. And Kamara is one for me this year, only suspended 3 games. People are still kind of waiting on him and drafting him super late. Like I was able to get him. I may have reached a little bit on him, in the 5th round in my draft that I had last night. But going actually perfect segue. My tip is pay attention to the guys drafting around you. Wherever you pick, you want to kind of see where everybody else is picking and see what they've already drafted. If you're going into the 5th or 6th round, and you know, maybe you see somebody's doesn't have a quarterback yet, and there's still some top quarterbacks on the board, and you're like, well, I don't know if it's going to get back to me or if he's going to be there if I wait another round. So yeah, pay attention to the people around you. Pay attention to, especially if you're on the ends, because they have two picks in a row. And very easily could take any guy that is that you're looking at. So, again, you know, pay attention to the draft. Pay attention to the guys around you. See what they need. See what you need. And if you have a guy in mind that could help you, and you don't want these other guys to get him, take him.
So what you're saying, Adam, brilliant. You got to know if you're going to be that late quarterback guy, and you're like, and to put in what Dave was saying too. This all three of you, right? This works perfect. Watch teams around you, late round value, pick your point. If you're that late round quarterback guy, I just did it in my league. My fade point was like, I want it. I don't know. You know, you guys saw my ranking. So say my fade point was Herbert. You know, Herbert went. And now it's time to wait. But I had a second fade point of Anthony Richardson. So I went and got Anthony Richardson. But I took him first. And I'm not even starting him week one because I ended up getting Dak later. And Dak's my starter week one. But the potential of Anthony Richardson could just be like Justin Fields was last year. So, you know, I just – and that ties all three together of I didn't get Herbert, Jackson, any of those guys. I just waited, and I was happy with where it ended.
Yeah, and my draft last night, like, I waited on a quarterback because the top guys were gone. Like, so it went Josh Allen, Patrick Mahomes, Jalen Hurts, of course, and then it went Joe Burrow, Justin Herbert. Like, those are the top guys, right? Anything after that, you're looking at similar value there. And in my league, I ended up drafting Tua in like the 11th round. So am I happy with Tua? I'm concerned about his injuries, but he played very well when he was on the field last year. As if he can stay on the field again, I'm hoping that 11th round value there in my starting quarterback is going to blow up for me.
So
I paid attention, I paid attention to everybody around me, and, you know, I was able to wait on a quarterback because I knew that these other guys were going, they're still going for receivers and running backs. And at that point in the draft, there's really not that many left. So I was able to wait and still get Tua.
But this could come back to haunt you. And me, Jay, and Dave all saw it in our draft the other night because we had, and insane. This is not an exaggeration, and these guys are going to back me up, we had two teams try to reinvent the wheel and take two tight ends within six rounds because they're going to start them in their flex. So you're going to start. So one team took Kelsey in the first round and Darren Waller in the fourth round. And okay.
That's odd.
And then they took a third tight end not too long after that either.
Hence why I ended up with Mr. Freiermuth.
Right. So and I'm kind of okay with that. Maybe Waller could be worth a flex, right?
Or the run on QBs that we had, which was insane as well.
It's the tight ends that drove me crazy, and then
yeah,
and then Lauren took Hockenson, and then took Goddard, and like that one bothered me because I don't think Dallas Goddard is flex worthy. Dallas Goddard is good because he's a tight end, and tight ends are kind of crappy. You know, Dallas Goddard is going to get you your 10 to 13 points. But, like, right. At that point in the draft, there's way better flex options. Way better flex options. So, yeah. So it's just this mentality also of, well, I'm going to keep them away from your team. That's fine. You just literally wasted your fifth round pick. Literally.
Yeah. You know, and Dallas Goddard's a funny one you bring up, too, because I don't think he ever had more than, like, five receptions in a game. Maybe once or twice last season. But, like, a flex guy, I want to be able to get, like, six, seven catches. Like, I'd much rather, especially if it's PPR, I want a guy in my flex that I know is going to catch the ball a ton.
Right. And that's, again, that's why Dave in that league ended up with the Muth. Who did you end up with, Jay? You went late too, didn't you?
Tyler Higbee.
Higbee. And I ended up getting, what did I say? Oh, Cole Kmet and Dalton Schultz later. So it's just kind of like, okay. At that point, like once we got to like the fifth round and two teams had two tight ends, I'm like, I'm fucking out. I'm done. Like, there's no way. So, interesting. Yeah, so
that goes with Dave's point of view. That's your fade point, right? So,
so the last one, guys, and that's why I want to go last, because I think it's one of the most important things to do with fantasy football. And sometimes a lot of you forget it at home, and a lot of you don't realize this, but have fun. This is supposed to be fun. Don't fucking have a fucking existential crisis because your second string, your RB2 scored 7 points, and now you're literally in a bout of depression and telling your friends to go fuck themselves. Like, we give each other a hard time on here. We like to burst each other's balls. Nobody ever takes anything personal.
Dave was pretty depressed at the draft when he didn't get Hopkins, so.
I am surprised.
He was more depressed when he had to take Bijan.
I'm surprised Dave's on the episode today, to be honest. But
I told you, bro. It's all love. It's all
love. I have this, I don't know if he listens, but this was years ago. A buddy of ours, James, long time ago. I remember I was playing him in fantasy, and he was at least. I don't know how he's now. He's a bit of a sore loser. And I remember, like, I met him up out at a bar. This is like 2010. Oh, I'll tell you exactly what it was. We walked into the bar, and it was the night that Sebastian Janikowski kicked the 63-yard field goal to tie the record. And I had Sebastian Janikowski. And this league we were in was just all fucked up. That 63-yard field goal got like 20 points. I don't know. Shit. It was just something crazy. This motherfucker literally, like, put his hands on me and told me to go fuck myself. And he's kind of a small guy, and I'm a big dude, and I love the kid. But I grabbed him and, like, had him pinned up against the wall up in the air. Was like, don't you ever fucking put your hands on me over a fucking fantasy football game. I mean, this is supposed to be fun. Yeah, there's money involved, but we want to win money. But you're probably in a league of friends or family, and even if not, there's always respect and there's always something, and that's the way it's supposed to be. If you're I'm in Dave's league, I don't really know all the guys in his league, but I've been in leagues with the league with them for 3, 4, 5 years now, so, like, there's respect, and I'm never gonna take anything these guys do personally or hate the person. Like, your boy Ed literally fucking snaked me 3 rounds in a row, and I was like beside myself. I don't hate Ed for it. It's so, like, there's so many people that take this shit personally. They'll stop talking to their friends because of a fantasy football trade or something. I don't know. This is supposed to be fun, guys. And that's the major takeaway for all this, is have fucking fun. Don't take it so goddamn seriously.
Absolutely. I completely agree with that. That just sums up everything. Have fun with it. Be, you know, like you said, we love the shit talk, but we're all friends at the end of the day, you know, and we're going to be friends long after fantasy football is, you know, the season and everything is over. And that's really important for sure, is, you know, look at these tips and take them seriously, we hope. But yeah, have fun with it. Definitely have fun with it. Fantasy football is a fun game, and I love draft season. I think I love the draft more than I love the actual season. So if I could just draft fantasy football and then not have to worry about it, which best ball leagues, I know that you can do that. Mm. But I'm talking just like leagues in general, just to draft and just leave it. And I'm so happy about that. I love drafting. It's so much fun. It's so much fun to see where people are drafting and how people think and what they're thinking about. And I do have another one too, and it kind of goes with everything. Just, you know, with Chaz's don't tinker thing, just always trust your gut and just go with it. I do have an announcement though, guys.
Okay.
I don't know if you guys looked at the comments on the last video. Somebody got our mystery player.
Let's go.
So tell us what the final clues were again before you give out the.
So the final clues that I gave out in the last episode, I have them right here. Was after college, I went on to be drafted 28th overall. I racked up 8,111 yards, 65 touchdowns, and I'm officially entering my 13th season in the NFL. So that was the hints. Do you guys have any idea who it could have been?
I see. I remember from your college thing, you're saying it was an SEC player.
It was an SEC college, and I'll give you the college.
Okay.
Alabama.
I believe you did say Alabama because I threw out.
Not say Alabama.
Okay. Well, I threw out.
I did not give the college because I knew that would give it away.
So Alabama, oldie but a goodie. With 8,000 yards, that's probably a running back.
It is a running back.
TJ Yeldon.
I don't think he's even close to 8,000 yards. But the answer is Mark Ingram. Mm.
It
was the one that I was thinking of. And Christy Legowski, who got the answer correctly, is actually a friend of mine. I know who she is. We've hung out before. She has the right answer here in the comments. So $25 gift card to Amazon.
Hey, congratulations.
Let's go. I'll reach out to her later and set that up. And that was fun.
You know what
you got it though.
You know what you get, Christy? You know what you get?
She's a big, she's a fan of the show. She texts me about it all the time. So super cool that she was able to do that. And good for her. $25 coming her way.
Congratulations. And like, was one of your possible clues ever going to be that the dude won the Heisman Trophy, or was that just like not going to come out?
So, yeah, I thought about it, but I didn't want to be too obvious,
right? Yeah,
especially with the first clues. I could have threw that in there, and then it just eliminates the pool completely. So gosh. I really was kind of hoping for like more of his NFL career to be what people got.
Can I have permission to go on a small tirade about Mark Ingram and winning the Heisman?
Go ahead.
Okay, so here it is. As you guys know,
this is your world, bro. We're just living in it.
As you guys know, I'm a college football fan. Oh, and I hope my camera's all right. I forgot to put up my ring light. Never mind. But I'm a college football guy. I'm a big, you know, Heisman Trophy guy, all that stuff. Reggie Bush deserves his Heisman back. Fuck you, NCAA. Anyway, so Mark Ingram wins the goddamn Heisman Trophy, and I have a real bone to pick with that because it was the most undeserved Heisman Trophy winner in my lifetime. And what I mean by that is I just felt like they wanted to do something with a running back and a big school, and there might have been some other stuff going on behind the scenes I won't get into, but Mark Ingram, the top two people to up for the Heisman that year was Mark Ingram from Alabama and Toby Gerhart, running back from Stanford. Here's the thing. Obviously, Mark Ingram had the better, I guess, NFL career and all that stuff. But Toby Gerhart led the league in rushing yards, rushing touchdowns, all that. So how the fuck does Mark Ingram get the goddamn Heisman over the guy that beat him in every statistical category whatsoever? Why? Because he went to fucking Alabama. That's the only reason why he beat Toby.
Yeah, you're probably right about that.
Toby Gerhart. You guys remember Toby Gerhart, the big white guy?
Yeah.
He should have won the Heisman Trophy that year. And I said he was a big white guy. There was a string there at that time. I'm not calling racism, but there was a string there that like six, seven like white quarterbacks won in a row. So like, was there something behind the scenes that they wanted to get it away from a white guy? Because there was no reason that Mark Ingram should have beat Toby Gerhart like that year. Mark Ingram's a better running back by all means. But he had no statistical categories better. And that wasn't even, I believe, Alabama didn't even win the national championship or anything that year.
So I don't think it was that year that he won the Heisman. No, you're right.
Yeah.
So they did win the championship while he was there, but I don't think it was that year.
I'm not even sure if they did or not, to be safe, because back in 07 and 08.
They did, because my last hints was that I literally said I won one national championship.
Oh, that's right. Okay. So like, yeah, but I don't, maybe it was.
Hey, dude, do you even pay attention to me?
It could have been the Heisman.
No.
But to also be fair, I think the Heisman Trophy comes out, gets awarded before the national championship game anyway. So like.
I believe it does.
So there was
so
no
didn't matter anyway.
Reason that he should have beat Toby Gerhart. And I always hated that. And it just because it just felt like dirty. Like how is this guy winning? It kind of felt dirty. Like, you know, when Aaron Rodgers beat Josh Allen for the MVP in 2020, it shouldn't have happened. There was no reason it should happen. So that was my little tirade about Mark Ingram winning the Heisman. It was the most undeserved Heisman Trophy winning ever.
Yeah. I can see your point there. But congrats, Christy. I'll reach out to her later on and get that all set up. But
so are we going to do the game you made us play last week, Adam?
Yeah, let's do it.
Or do I love how your last tip is have fun and don't get depressed. And then you just go on this like 10-minute tirade of just anger and rage.
It's been building up for 15 years.
Like the rage filled rant.
Did not deserve the Heisman Trophy. And I remember thinking it then, like, how does that happen? And I felt, you guys know I'm very passionate about Josh not winning it in 2020. Because it shouldn't have happened that way. So, Adam, what was that game we played called?
Weddlegame.com.
Weddle. Jay wasn't here for this, was he?
No. He was not.
And I'm sure he didn't watch the episode, so.
No.
See, exactly.
So, Jay, basically what this is there's the easy version and there's the hard version, right? So we're going to do both. So basically what you do is you guess NFL players. The first game is only offensive players. So it's wide receivers, running backs, quarterbacks, tight ends. And then when we switch over to the hard one, it's every player in the NFL. Offense, defense, offensive line, defensive line, linebackers, anything. So we have 8 guesses to guess the player that is here. That
oh, boy.
The game was thinking of. So
it's like Wordle.
So it's basically Wordle. We have 8 guesses to guess the player that they're thinking of, and then we'll go on to the hard one, and then we'll go from there.
So we got it on screen, and I'm just going to start with Josh Allen, just because it's probably not going to be him, but I just have a good gauge of when he was drafted, because it gives you certain cues, Jay, like a year and position.
No, so this isn't the draft one. This is just the player. So okay. it's going to give us – it'll give us AFC, NFC. It'll give us division. It'll give us position. It'll give us, like, his age, his number. And then there's little arrows, and if we're close, it turns yellow. But if we get it, it'll turn green. So.
Okay. So we're going to start. Our first guess is Josh Allen.
I like it.
Buffalo. Ready? Let's go.
Bang.
So he is in the AFC. So now if you guys are looking on the screen, the AFC is yellow. Everything else is gray. So that means
so
he's in the AFC.
No NFC teams can be – no NFC players are on this – in this guess.
Shorter than 6'5".
Yeah. And his number is lower than 17.
And he's older than 27.
And he's not a quarterback.
He's not a quarterback. So
now we're looking at wide receivers, tight ends, and running backs.
Dalvin Cook. No, yeah. Not in the East. Not in the East. Never mind.
Yeah.
Not in the East. So we're looking at West, North, and South. So let's go with a running back. Let's go with – how tall is Derrick Henry?
He's 6'6".
Oh shit!
So he's shorter than 6'5".
He's too big.
So he's got to be older than drafted in 2018.
Yeah. No, not drafted. Oh, maybe. Well, yeah. I guess you can figure that out from the age, right?
Okay. So what about? Here's one. What about? Because it kind of fits what we're looking for. What about? Oh God, I'm drawing a blank. Okay, Amari Cooper.
Okay.
Okay. So.
All right.
So he's not in the AFC North, but he is a receiver. And he's older than 29, and he's
6'1".
So we're looking at the West and the South.
Could it be? What number? 2?
Higher than 2? Higher than 2, lower than 17.
Could it be, Dave, DeAndre Hopkins?
Let's go.
It could be. It could be. I think you guys might be right here.
Yeah.
Let's go.
Let's go.
Hey, let's go.
You got it.
Yo, Jay, how about that trade, bro?
Let's go. Yes, DeAndre Hopkins.
That was nasty. What did we get it in?
Good job, 3.
3 picks.
Nice.
That's not bad.
That's so nice. Awesome.
You guys want to try the hard one?
Yeah, let's try the hard one.
Okay, so Josh Allen's a good starting point, right?
This is defense, sure. Too, right?
It's everybody in the NFL, yeah. Every active player in the NFL.
Okay. Here we go. So, he's in the NFC.
NFC.
So that's good.
He's not on offense.
And he's shorter than.
Well, it's not a quarterback, so it could be anything, really. So let's go NFC.
So he is older than 27, higher number, and shorter than 6'5". So that could be so much so.
So that could
AJ Brown.
Could eliminate a lot.
He's younger than 27.
Oh.
Yes, AJ Brown.
Yeah, he might be 26.
He's like 25, 26.
Adam Thielen.
Yeah, he's definitely older.
Yeah, let's NFC.
Let's try.
Do it. NFC.
If we bang this on the second try, this would be so nasty.
Here we go.
Fire.
Okay. Ooh, he got his age at 30.
Got the age right.
So he's about 6'3 or 6'4. Yeah. So, okay. So he's tall. So this is a lineman.
I think. Definitely. Yeah, I think so.
You think so?
Yeah. He's tall. He's 6'4 or 3, and he's not a quarterback or a receiver.
And he's 32.
Okay. Unless he's a tight end.
And he's got a higher number than 19.
Yeah. Unless he's a tight end too. So I mean, that could be.
Well, let's try a lineman.
Let's try to get somebody in the NFC East. Is Tyron Smith still there?
Let's go Fletcher Cox.
That's fucking old. Okay, that's fine. That's the same.
I mean, he's not like super old, is he?
I think
he's got to be around.
Is he 32?
I think he's like 35. No,
oh shit!
Whoa, look at that, Adam. Nice.
Holy shit!
Look at that.
Oh my god, that's awesome. Insane.
Let's go.
Good job.
Oh my god.
Holy shit!
I think we should retire from Weddle. I don't know if this could get any better.
That's that was insane. Great.
What was the draft one?
There should be a link on the bottom there.
That, Draftle.
Oh yeah, Draftle.
All right, so this is the same thing, kind of, Jay, except
same kind of thing. It's draft picks though. When a player was drafted.
This is more my style. So
this is more for Chaz, really. Wow, yeah, I can't believe I nailed those all both on the third try.
Adam, you're gonna get this.
Yeah.
Good job, buddy.
Yeah.
That was nasty.
All right,
that
here
was
we go.
Insane.
Josh Allen. Okay, so the guy's drafted in 18. He was
higher than the first round.
So he's a first round pick, right?
Higher than the first.
No, round. Higher, but close.
Yeah,
how could it be higher? So
second round pick, third round pick, maybe.
Wouldn't it be lower if it was the first?
Well, he can't be lower than a first round pick, dude.
No, you know what I mean, like next round.
Okay, I see.
No, I know. Oh. Yeah, no. I'm talking to Chaz. Is like, couldn't it be lower? I'm like, well, you can't go lower than the first round.
So he's an AFC. AFC person drafted in 2018.
Probably second round.
Non-QB.
Non-QB.
I think with this one, it goes. So it should be the second round. I don't think it goes higher than that. It could be the third. Because if it is the second, the third would be third round would also be yellow. Right.
Well, so we don't have to do all, 2018 picks if we want to, like, hammer it down a little bit. So you could do like.
So it's a non-QB, though. So.
Yeah. So you can think of it's not an AFC East team. It could be an AFC South team. So right. I know it'll like pull us out of it. But let's say DeAndre Hopkins anyway. It's not. But let's see if it gives us any help here.
Now, what running backs were drafted in 18?
That was Saquon Barkley, Bashard Penny. Was that Sony Michel too? But those are all first rounders. So we know it's either east or it's either north or west now.
Right.
Yeah.
When was
Mixon drafted?
Yeah.
17.
Shit.
But if you want me to put him, it will help us narrow it down a little bit.
Yeah, go Joe Mixon just to see if we get some different.
Okay, so AFC North, and he's from Oklahoma.
And it's not a running back.
So it's a 2018, not Oklahoma.
Not QB, not wide receiver, not running back.
So it's higher than a second round, so it's like a third round pick.
So it's got to be a tight end.
It's got to be a tight end, yeah.
What tight ends were drafted in 2000? From Oklahoma.
Oh God.
Yeah, this is your wheelhouse, Chaz, because I am not a draft guy.
Yeah, Sam.
Evan Engram.
Ooh, no, I think he was 17. I'll put him there though.
Try it though.
I'll put him there because no, but that's NFC. So I don't want to waste it. I don't want to waste that because he was drafted by the Giants.
Oh true. Yeah.
Oh, I got it. I think. Boom!
There it is. Let's go.
Took me a minute.
Mark Andrews. Wow.
Took me a second, nice but I got it.
Let's go. Let's go.
The draft guy, right?
We're pretty good at this game. Well, Chaz is pretty well. Chaz and Adam are pretty good at this game.
Yeah, mind you, folks, about that. You know how I deduced that, guys? Because Mark Andrew was their fourth round pick. Their first round pick that year, 23rd overall, the Baltimore Ravens, was Hayden Hurst, tight end. And then they traded up to take Lamar Jackson, and then they picked Mark Andrews later. So it was a pretty good draft for the Ravens that year.
Yeah. All right, let's go on to the hard one.
All right, let's do the hard one. We'll start with Josh, right?
Do we start with Josh again? Okay.
Josh, he's a good aiming point.
That's a good starting point. All right, first rounder.
He's offense.
And he's on offense, first round pick. Nice.
NFC offense, first round pick, higher than seventh overall, and he's younger than Josh.
Okay, so let's see.
It's not a quarterback.
What year? I can't see the arrow on that. Is it up or down?
It's up.
So let's try to deduce it and go over here for DeAndre Swift, right? Because this is going to do 2020 and second round 2020. DeAndre, am I spelling it right?
Well, it is a first rounder.
Just put in Swift.
He was a second. Oh, it is a first rounder. You're right.
Yeah, no, it is a first round. It's guaranteed a first round pick.
But I'm trying to see if it's NFC, right? So we need NFC. That's why I'm saying Swift, just to get some of that. So.
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay. So that's good.
So it's older than 2020.
New draft player.
Okay. So it's somebody in 2021 or two. So let me try 22 for a receiver. So a receiver drafted last year.
Well, it could be a defensive player too. Or no, it is offense. Okay. Sorry.
No, it's offense.
I'm going to throw out this random receiver that sucks. How do you even spell Velus Jones? Velus Jones Jr., the receiver from Chicago, drafted in 2022. So this guy's drafted in 2021. So he's a receiver.
He's a wide receiver.
And he's from the NFC South or East?
East or West.
East.
Who's the first one? Who was the first round wide receivers of 2021?
2021, that would have been what? Oh, my goodness. Oh,
the Jefferson?
No. It could be Jefferson.
CeeDee Lamb.
CeeDee Lamb, probably. Okay, no.
Okay, oh, NFC
2020.
East.
He was 2020. So, okay.
This is good, though. We got NFC East wide receiver, first round, 2021. And higher than the 17th pick.
The first overall pick, I'm just trying to get my mind in the space. The first overall pick of 2021 was Lawrence. Okay, yeah. So that was Lawrence. That was all those guys. So it's a higher draft pick than 17, and it's a receiver. So after
– And the NFC East. So
NFC East. So it's the East.
When was DeVonta Smith drafted?
Fifth overall. So hang on. So the Eagles, the Reds.
Giants.
Was it Jahan Dotson? No, Dotson was 22.
What about McLaurin?
No, he was a second round pick. Oh, I got it. I know it. I have it. Here it is. Here it is right here. Kadarius Toney. That's who it is. Kadarius Toney.
Jesus Christ.
Look at this guy. Oh my God. You are the draft guru though, that's for sure. You definitely know your draft shit. So
Thank you. I try.
What a fucking good run we had today, boys. We should never play this game again. we're never going to do better than what we just did.
And think about that guy. Kadarius Toney was a first-round draft pick just 2 years ago. The fucking Kansas City Chiefs stole this guy for nothing. Nothing. So keep that in mind for fantasy. But then again, the dude basically has one leg at all times.
Yeah.
If you and your boys got a fantasy football podcast out there, we challenge you. We challenge you to Wordle right now.
Yo, you guys should put me on Hurdle or whatever that is, or Draftle against Mel Kiper, because that guy doesn't know jack shit. So.
No, that dude's
Oh, maybe he'll see this and you can reach out. He'll reach out to us.
Yeah, maybe.
I'm so mad I didn't set up my fucking ring light. I look fucking.
We challenge you, Mel Kiper. We challenge you, bro.
Yeah.
Mel Kiper.
I love that.
Your fucking toupee.
Bitch.
I'm going to fucking make a Mel Kiper YouTube and troll you so fucking hard.
I love that idea.
Well, guys, the Fantasy Football Bros podcast official draft is in what, five days from now?
Yep.
Five days from now.
As you guys are getting this. actually four days from now, because I have John is going to upload this tomorrow morning. So, you know, we're going to have new days coming through, everybody at home. I know this usually gets posted on the YouTube about Wednesday and on the podcast forums about Thursday or Friday, but we're switching because we got to get, you know, more of a review once the season starts. So the new podcast will be out on Tuesdays. We're going to record Monday nights. And so guys, set your calendars for Tuesdays to get your review and your preview and all your fancy advice from us.
Sounds good.
Get ready for that. And I know that's probably breaking news to you guys, but
not really. We did it last year too. So,
but you guys ready for the draft? Where Jay, where are you picking?
I don't know. Somewhere.
Yeah. Somewhere like that. Me too. I think I'm 10th.
I think I'm like 7th.
I think I'm 12th or 11th. I think
We're kind of all at the ass end.
I'm at the ass end.
Is Dave 5th?
After I got eliminated, I was like, I'm done with this.
I'm not going to pretend to know where I am, but I do believe it's somewhere around 4, 5, 6.
Yeah, I think you're out there. So so far I've had 3 drafts, everybody. And I've had this will be my 3rd. I mean, and I've had pick 5, pick 7 and pick 10. So they're all kind of meh, but it doesn't matter what you do. The only thing your draft position matters, guys, is basically your first 2 picks, because then everything starts going off the rails after that.
Yeah,
it does.
Yeah.
It's basically your first 2 picks. And then it's just like, it doesn't matter. I've seen, you know, Dalton Kincaid go in the 4th round. I know in our other league, Chad, he took Odell Beckham like 4 rounds early just because he has a feeling. So it starts going off the rails. So be prepared.
It really does.
Be prepared. You guys saw all your tips and tricks and all that stuff. And I'll bring them back up here for a second so you guys can see them one last time. We'll go over those one last time, and we'll say our goodbyes, everybody. So here it is for everyone to see at home. You got your tips and tricks up on the screen here right now. If you guys can read them, Dave, give them your final tips and tricks here. What you got? Can you read it?
Yes, sir. Know your league. Don't be a ranking slut. And Frick your fade point. It's late, guys. Pick your fade point. Pick your fade point.
He's on a sugar high right now, guys.
I ate like 45 fucking Tootsie Rolls before I did this. I am hot. I'm ready to go. Hey,
you are showing your age. Tootsie Rolls.
I know.
You have a butterscotch candy in your pocket right now.
Listen, I love me a Werther's original, and no one can take that away from me.
Absolutely.
The ones that have like the green apple stuff in the middle.
Oh, yeah, those are good.
So
yeah,
they're bussing, y'all. They're bussing. Right, Jay, what are your tips here?
Mock drafts, have a plan, and late round value.
Yep, absolutely. Adam.
Yeah. Same as Dave. Number 1 is know your league and your settings. Number 2, same as Jay. Have a plan, be prepared to be flexible on that plan, abandon it at all costs if you need to. And then my last one is just pay attention to the guys drafting around you. Know who's drafting around you, know who they're drafting, know who they need, make your picks.
And then my final tips and tricks to win your league, guys, is don't tinker. Get your team together and don't overthink it. Do what you think is best. Also, draft your guys. Get your dude, even if you have to jump around early to get him. Get your fucking guy. You're going to kick yourself in the ass if he goes off on sitting on Jay's team. And the other one, the final one that we all need to remember is have fun. This is about having fun and bonding with your friends and family and having relationships grow and all that stuff. So have fun. Don't take it so seriously, but win that money, yo. All right, guys. So the song of the week after my concert run I've been on is a band I saw 2 Sundays ago, The Offspring and Sum 41 and Simple Plan. We're going to go with Sum 41. We're going to go with Sum 41, The Bitter End. And if you guys never heard the Sum 41, The Bitter End song, it literally is metal. It sounds like Metallica could have written this song. And their guitar player, Dave, is one of my biggest inspirations to pick up the guitar, you know, 20 years ago or so, because he's so much better than people give him credit for. So I want to give him some love. So this is Sum 41, The Bitter End. All right. So Jay, thank you. I'm glad you're feeling better, and thank you for joining us.
Yep, no problem.
Dave, I'm glad you're feeling better after Jay grabbed your heart and stabbed it with a fucking like a butcher's knife. But you can't stab with a butcher's knife. And I'm the chef. What the fuck is that? Anyway, Dave, thank you for joining us.
It's all right. I'm gonna get through it, and this bad boy ain't going anywhere.
Oh, he's got it back. All right. Hey, man, you can flex it. That's fine. And Adam, as always, thank you for joining us, and yes. Good luck on the move.
Thank you, guys. I appreciate it.
You better not get stuck in the airport, not be able to draft. So you're probably driving.
No, I'll be all right. I'm driving down, so I'll be able to draft. No problem.
Worst case, you better pull over to a fucking Sheetz or something and do the draft if you have to.
I'm leaving on Sunday. Draft is on Monday, so I am good to go.
Okay. That's what I want. Yeah, that's what I want
to go. Real quick, congratulations again to Christy. I'll reach out to her. Nice job on pulling that Mark Ingram mystery player from my hints. Yeah, happy to be here. As always, next time it'll be in Nashville. So,
and he's been saying forever, wait till I move to Nashville. I'm going to get a better setup. So now you're on the fucking clock, bitch.
It's going
to
happen. I'm going to go build it when I get down there.
All right. And everybody, make sure you guys like, comment, subscribe on YouTube. Make sure you're subscribed to us on all the podcast platforms and on TikTok. I got some more TikToks coming out for this last week or so. To the season starts next fucking week, guys. Can you believe it?
I am so ready for the start of football season.
I am so ready. So we got some more TikTok coming out for you. If these guys ever decide to make any, they'll be up too, but I've kind of given up on that hope. I haven't posted it yet, but keep your eyes out on our YouTube at the Fantasy Football Bros Podcast for the results of our Royal Rumble for the Fantasy Football Draft Order. I did hope post it on my personal channel, but I got to remember to, you know, release it on the Fantasy Football Bros channel. So that's probably up now as you're hearing this, because I'm probably going to do it when I get done here. All right, everybody, thanks for checking out the podcast. Until then, yes. We will see you next time. Peace.
See you guys.
Later, guys. Later, guys.
The preceding presentation has been brought to you by the Gear Network.